You have a project and everything is beautiful, it works wonderfully, everybody loves it. And one day, a success comes. Your product becomes a success. And do you know what also comes with success? The increased influx of requests. And what happens next is that your production server crumbles and fails. That is the curse of programming. The success comes with a failing production server. Have you seen that already? Nevertheless, there is one technique that may just save you in the critical situation, and that technique I will show you in this video. You will rarely ever need this technique, but once you do need it, it might easily be the only chance you have. This is a very simple simulation of an endpoint. It receives some data, the array of person objects. Person is just a very small model. I needed something. It plays no role in this demo. What does play the role is the loop in this endpoint. You will be doing something with each of the objects you receive. I will then accumulate the delays in the loop, and every time the accumulated delay grows above 1 millisecond, I will let the endpoint sleep for that long. That will make requests start piling up. This is the client side. It's very simple, but just as I said, the world is changing, your project is now a success. Every once in a while, like during 1 hour per day, it comes that the requests become very large and there are many, many concurrent requests, like 400 concurrent requests over a prolonged period of time. Let's see what the server will do this time. What I see is that it is not responsive anymore. There is a gap in reports. The gaps happen all the time. It should be reporting once in every second, but it is not. And the memory, oh, 14, 16, 17 gigabytes. Any regular server would already fail. How can you react to such a spike in the use of your application? I will copy this entire endpoint and paste it again because I want to implement another one, and I'm calling it streaming. Now you already see in which direction I'm thinking. Here is what really happened on my server. It is requesting an array of person objects. An array means that the server will need to receive the entire JSON through the connection and then deserialize the entire JSON from the request. But not a single instruction inside of this endpoint begins executing because it's still waiting for the data to be deserialized. And that's the reason why the memory footprint begins to grow on the server, up to the point when the entire server becomes unstable. A very simple solution is to not request the deserialized array, but to start from the HTTP context and do the deserialization yourself. Here is how it goes. You would take the body from the request object. That is the stream. So don't read anything from that stream yet. Let your endpoint start executing. Then start pulling the data and do your best to process them as you pull them from the socket. This is how you do that. Prepare the JSON serialization options. This is what the server would do for you, but now you have to do it yourself. And then use the JSON serializer, but use the special method called deserialize async enumerable and give it the type of the instance of the object. It returns an async enumerable of nullable person objects. This method is only applicable if the JSON you are receiving is the JSON array. It will process the incoming data by pulling them in chunks and deserializing individual elements of the JSON array and pushing each of them in form of an async enumerable so that you can start processing them while the rest of the data still haven't come to your application. And then you hope that will give your server enough time to gradually populate the memory with incoming data, and you hope that the memory footprint of the entire server will be sufficiently low that you survive. Anyway, the rest is straightforward. You would await for each for the sequence of objects, skip those that are null. This method may return a null because the incoming array of object could contain null instances. That's it. It's very simple, I told you. I want to test the new endpoint in the same way as I did with the first one. I have restarted the server. I'm eager to see the results. This is still the first endpoint. It is struggling dearly. 15 gigabytes, okay. And then comes the second endpoint, and look, server is responsive most of the time, and what it does is to complete execution of all the requests in time that is 4 times shorter, and the memory consumption, which is 20 times less than the first endpoint. That is everything I have to show you. Still, the question remains, does this work when the requests are small? We must test the regular case too, and that will surprise you as well. Before that, I have a favor to ask from you. If you like what you are learning from the videos on my channel, then please be advised that this channel and all the videos on it are free thanks to the people who are supporting this channel on my Patreon page. If you want to help me keep this channel free for everybody, then please join the growing community of supporters on my Patreon page and become a sponsor. Thank you very much. Now let's do the final check of this solution. I will return to the original set of parameters. Smaller requests, less concurrent requests, that's what I want to check. I will quickly run the simulation again. The first endpoint is fast and the memory footprint is totally within bounds. But look at the second run. The memory footprint is a bit lower. The time is pretty much the same as it was, and the server was fully responsive because it has responded once per second in both cases. Now, it's not easy to understand. How come that we didn't pay the cost of building an async enumerable compared to just an array? The array must be faster, like 10 to 1 when measured. The trick is in understanding what the server is doing. Most of the time, not CPU activity, but the time that passes, it spends waiting for I/O. And what about the memory footprint? It is a bit lower, but not dramatically in the second case, and the reason is the same as in the large simulation. The second endpoint is just starting to process the data a bit earlier than the first endpoint, and so its memory consumption is a bit lower. But that's not dramatic. That won't make a great impact. The great impact happens when things become hairy, when you have many concurrent large requests, then this technique, which you can see here, this technique of working asynchronously with the incoming stream of JSON data, that technique might just save your server. Remember, you will almost never need this. But once you do need it, this might be your only chance.